Hi, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Tri Julianti binti Yusuf, number matric H17A0347. We'll discuss about precede proceed model when conducting health promotion program. What is a precede proceed? Okay, as you know, precede proceed is a community-oriented participatory model for creating successful community health promotion intervention. Precede has a 5 phases. For the first phase is a social diagnosis. Second is an epidemiological diagnosis. Third is a behavioral and environmental diagnosis. Fourth, educational and organizational diagnosis. And the last one is an administrative and policy diagnosis. Phase 4 proceed is a continuous of precede phases, which is implementation, process evaluation, impact evaluation, and the last phases, which is a phase 9, is an outcome evaluation. When we start to do something, there's have a reason, right? So it's same for the precede proceed model. Why we use precede proceed model? That's because a logic model provides a procedural structure for constructing an intervention. A logic model provides a framework for critical analysis, and also a precede proceed model is participatory test assuring community involvement. Community involvement leads to community buy-in. Incorporate a multi-level evaluation, which means you have to change to constantly monitor and adjust your evaluation when using a precede proceed model. How do we use a precede proceed model? For the first phase, social diagnosis, you can ask the community what it wants and needs to improve its quality of life. For example, when we conducting a health promotion program, like a depression program before this, we have to ask a community on how they feel before the program. When we get a survey before a program, we can get information that what is a want and needs to improve a quality of life. For the second phase, is an epidemiological diagnosis, which is we can identify the health or other issues that most clearly influence the outcome the community seeks. For example, for the depression program, we can know the community that have a sign of depression, which is have a level of depression that they get. From these two phases, we can use and create the objective for our intervention. For the third phase, is a behavioral and environmental diagnosis, which is we can identify the behavior and lifestyle or environmental factor that must be changed to affect the health or other issue that identified in phase 2 and determine which of them are most likely to be changeable. So we continue to the phase 4, which is an educational and organizational diagnosis, which is we can identify the predisposing, enabling and reinforcing factor. In phase 5, which is administrative and policy diagnosis, we can identify and adjust, where necessary, the internal administrative issue and internal and external policy issues that can affect the successful conduct of the intervention. For phase 6, implementation, we can carry out the intervention. In phase 7, which is a process evaluation, we can evaluate the process of the intervention. For example, we can determine whether the intervention is proceeding according to plan and adjust accordingly. In phase 8, which is impact evaluation, we can evaluate whether the intervention is having the intent impact on the behavioral and environmental factor it aims at and adjust accordingly. For the phase 9, which is a last phase, outcome evaluation, we can evaluate whether the intervention effects are in turn producing the outcome the community identified in phase 1 and adjust accordingly. So, a precede proceed model is a very recommended for the future because it's a very important and help us to conducting a health promotion program by the precede proceed model. We can know more about our community and what are they have and facing a problem. A precede proceed model is a very important and give a more benefit to us as a conductor when we have to conduct a health promotion program, and we also can help a community to give a solution for the problem.
Thank you.